everyone, myself Vibhavi Raikar. Today I am with my group Snowdrop to present a seminar about a phases of initial public offering. We choose Snowdrop because I believe it's symbol of peace and purity. And I want to introduce my group members. First one, Zubeda, Vismita, Vrindavani, Vinesh, Yellappa and Venkatram. So we start the presentation. Now I would like to call Vrindavani to present her topic.
Myself, Vrindavani Karsunka. My topic is types of issue for the person. A follow-on opening is when a public company issues more share after their initial public offering. Thus, it happens when a company wants to raise more share after their after their finance project, pay their debt or make appreciation, then when a follow-on issuing offering, the shares they are giving out must be available to the general public, and it is available to existing shareholder. Additionally, the company must have already offered to IPO and be publicly listed on shareholder. There are two types of follow-on offering, first on related and second on non-related. Thank you. I would like to call Vinesh.
Sir, Vinesh, I told my topic is group building. Group building is a process on privacy, public discovery, offers and shares. It is the arrived on company state allowed of shares bid the which the shares. The method of the application issued arrived, cut off the shares manner of final privacy market word in the which the privacy cut by cut off shares the public of shares holders demand subject of the initial public offers aramika sarvajanika kodugegalu this public offers shares. Thank you. I would call to Zubeda presentation.
Myself Zubeda Raikar. My topic is book building processes. Book building is a common practice developed in the countries and has made inroads into emerging market as well. All public issues in the book building will see a minimum number of applications and large order size per applications. All book building is conducted off market, but most stock exchange have rules that require to be on market. Trading is related to be processing in the book building. When a company wants a rise money, it plans on offering a stock here to the public. This typically takes place for either in IPO or FPO. IPO means initial public offer. The book building processes helps determine in the security. Thank you. I want to call Vismita Kumar. Vismita Kumar, my topic is the issue of trade ಸರಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಬಳಸುವ ವಿಧಾನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಥಿರತೆಯು ಒಂದು ವಿಧಾನವಾಗಿದೆ. ಇತರ ಕಂಪನಿಯ ಐಪಿಒ IPO ಅನ್ನು IPO ಅನ್ನು ಸಾಂಸ್ಥಿಕ ಹೂಡಿಕೆದಾರರಿಗೆ ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡಲಾಗುತ್ತದೆ ಕನಿಷ್ಠ 90% ಮೌಲ್ಯದ ಹಣವನ್ನು ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತದೆ ಇಲ್ಲದಿದ್ದರೆ ಸೇವೆಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಮರುಪಾವತಿಸಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತದೆ ಅಂತಿಮವಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಣವನ್ನು ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸಿದ ನಂತರ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಮಾಣಪತ್ರವನ್ನು ನೀಡಲಾಗುತ್ತದೆ ಪಾವತಿಸದೇ ಇಲ್ಲದವರಿಗೆ ನೋಟಿಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕಳುಹಿಸಲಾಗುತ್ತದೆ
ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರೆಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ನಾನಿಂದು ಮಾಡುವ ಸಾಧಿಕೆನಂದರೆ ಸ್ಥಿರ ಬಲ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಸ್ಥಿರ ಬಲ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ಕಂಪ್ನಿಯು ತಯಾರಿಸಿದಾಗ ಆ ವಸ್ತುಗೆ ಆ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಯವರು ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಆರ್ಥಿಕ ಆಗಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಂಶವನ್ನು ಸೇರಿ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತುಗೆ ಬೆಲೆ ನಿಗದಿಪಡಿಸುತ್ತಾರೆ ಆ ನಿಗದಿಪಡಿಸಿದ್ರಿಂದ ಕೆಲವರಿಗೆ ಖರೀದಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳೋಕೆ ಆಗಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಹೂಡಿಕೆದಾರಿಗೆ ಆಗಬಹುದು ಅದರಿಂದ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಸರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನನಗೆ ವಿಧಿಸಲಾದ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತುಗೆ ವಿಧಿಸಲಾದ ಶುಲ್ಕವನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಸರಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡೋದರಿಂದ ಖರೀದಿದಾರರಿಗೆ ಅನುಕೂಲವಾಗುತ್ತದೆ ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಆವಾಗಲೂ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಯನ್ನು ಸಹ ತನ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗುಣಾತ್ಮಕ ಪರಿಣಾತ್ಮಕ ಬೆಲೆಯನ್ನು ಅನುಸರಿಸಿ ಒಂದು ಆ ವಸ್ತುಗೆ ಬೆಲೆಯನ್ನು ನಿಗದಿಪಡಿಸುತ್ತೆ ಆದರೂ ಅದೇ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಖರೀದಿಗಾರರು ಭಾಳ ಆಸಕ್ತಿಯಿಂದ ಕಳೆದುಕೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗೆ ವಸ್ತುಗಳು ಮಾರಾಟವಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಆದರೆ ಲಾಭದಾಯಕವಾಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಆ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ನಿಗೆ ಧನಾತ್ಮಕವಾಗಿ ಅಥವಾ ಋಣಾತ್ಮಕವಾಗಿಯೂ ಲಾಭ ಆಗಬಹುದು ಅಥವಾ ಆಗದೇ ಇರಬಹುದು ಇದರಿಂದ ಕಂಪನಿಗೆ ಸ್ಥಿರ ಬೆಲೆ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಎಂದು ಕಾಣುತ್ತದೆ ಇಂದು ಈಗ ನನ್ನ ಕಡೆ ಮುಂದಿರುವ ಇಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಕಡೆ ಮಾಡಲು
prepared, introduced, a new business or product for potential investors. It also outlines a formal company and it also includes risk hazard to the company and it also taking contains information about the background of the company, key facts about the fundraising, how fundraising is defined, etc. And contents of the red herring prospects is liability and second one is company background
Hello everybody, my name is Venkat Rao Puneet and today I will present a seminar on green shoe options. Green shoe option is a provision in an underwriter's agreement which enables the underwriter to sell more shares than what was originally planned. This measure is taken when the market price of a share increases higher than the offer price, which can lead to price fluctuations and jeopardize the investor's wealth. The Securities Exchange Board of India allows for this option to be exercised within 6 days of the IPO, and the maximum number of shares allowed to be issued after the IPO is 15% of the IPO size. A modified version of the green shoe option is when the market price of share goes down below the offer price, in which case the underwriters purchases more shares from the public or the company, either fully or partially. Let's say, for example, company X, with the assistance of underwriter Y, issues 10,000 shares of rupees 100 each to the public. And immediately after the IPO, the price of the shares goes to rupees 125, in which case the underwriter sells 11% more shares, that is 1,100 shares, to try and stabilize the price. In case the price of the share goes down to rupees 20, that is to rupees 80 from 100, then the underwriter undertakes the responsibility of owning the shares by either purchasing from the company or the public, and also making a small amount of profit out of it. Thank you.
IPO. If the share are offered at a fixed price, this issue is not a fixed price. This is the second most preferred way of initial public offering. In the offer document, the issuer has to be reasonable and proper justification for the price. Demand for the securities can be based on the subscription issue, and this only happens when the subscription is over. This method has become less often in the view of the first certificate media. The chances of fixing a fair price of companies is very rare. Thank you.
Myself Varsha Naikar. My topic is method of making public issue or public reference to the issue of shares convertible securities in the primary market. Methods of public issue, initial public offer, an unlisted company is a public company that is neither on a stock